Hello everyone and welcome back to RoboFreaks. The game which we are going to build today requires no introduction as it has already claimed its spot in the best and most downloaded games of 2020. Yes, it is none other than Among Us. If you have been following our videos, you know we are going to have a lot of fun today. And if you haven't already subscribed, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to RoboFreaks for more such amazing game development videos and tutorials. With that being said, let's get started. We are going to make this game in two parts. Let's see a quick demo of what we will be building in part 1 of the video. The game starts with our main character standing on a very zoomed in map. We can move around the map using the arrow keys. And you may notice that as we move, the background keeps changing smoothly. So cool, right? We can also interact with the objects present on the map by touching them. And in part 2, we will be adding tasks when the player touches those computers. The game seems easy to play, but we are going to learn a lot of new things while creating it. Let's dive into coding our very own Among Us in Scratch. I will start by naming the game. Since this is the part 1, I'll mention it in the name too. We will import the two main sprites first, which have been provided in the description below. Just download them and upload using the Upload Sprite button. Now that we have imported the map and main character, we can start placing them properly. I will hide the main character for now and focus on the map. We saw in the demo that our map was very zoomed in. Since you all are familiar with the Scratch, you might be thinking we can simply zoom the map sprite by increasing this size to some big number. Let's try that. I'll set the size to 150. Okay, it zoomed. But we need much more zoom, right? I will try again and this time I'll set it to 300. Oops, what just happened? Even though we wrote 300, the size was set to 179. What are we doing wrong? I'll try the same thing with the other sprite to make sure I'm not doing anything wrong. I will unhide the main character and set size to 300. Hey, this worked. Let's increase a little more. This time it's stuck at 395. Why is Scratch doing this with us? Why? Well, I know why. Scratch does not allow the sprite size to be increased after a certain range. And this range depends on the original size of sprite. Smaller sprites have a higher zoom level. That is why we were able to zoom till 395% on our main character. While only 179% for our map. But we need some sort of hack to zoom more into the map. And I'm going to tell you that hack. As I told you that, smaller sprites can be zoomed more. What we will do is create another costume in our map sprite and leave it blank. That's it. Time to full Scratch. Open the code editor now. When the flag is clicked, we will switch the costume to blank costume. Since it is really small, we can zoom it a lot. I'll set zoom to 600%. And then switch the costume back to full map. And show. Ta-da! Our trick worked. And we are able to zoom now. Let's place the map sprite in the center of the screen when game starts. It's time to give some motion to our character. Grab the green flag block. We need to reduce the size of our character to 30. And also bring it on the top of the map using the go to front layer block. Set the position at the center in the beginning. Now in a forever block, we will continuously check which arrow key is pressed. And move our character in that direction. If right arrow key is pressed, we will make our character point rightwards. And same for the left arrow key. Set the rotation style to left right so that our sprite flips rather than completely rotate. Well, now comes the fun part. We have given motion to sprites in almost all our games. But today, we will be doing something different. We won't move our sprite at all. Sounds stupid, right? We want to move, but we won't be moving. Well, let us understand something called relative motion. Don't freak out, it's a very simple idea. Suppose you are traveling to your village by a train and decide to look outside the window. And what do you see? Everything starts moving backward. The trees, grass, farms, clouds, everything. But in reality, you are moving and everything else is at rest. It depends on where you are observing the world from. For someone inside the train, the whole world is moving backwards. And someone who views from outside will say the train is moving forward. We will use this idea in our game's motion too. Instead of moving the character, we will move the whole map in such a way that it appears that our character is moving, but it does not move at all. So how do we do this? I will create two new variables which will store the amount of motion in X and Y axis. I will name these variables as scroll X and scroll Y. Set them to 0 initially. Now depending on the arrow key, we will update these variables. I will explain how this will help us. To update these variables, I'll create a custom scratch block named move, which will take two values as input, the X and Y positions. And all this function will do is change the scroll values by given X and Y values. Let us use this block in the if statements we have created. When the right arrow key is pressed, we will change X by 10 and Y will not change. Similarly for the left, X will change by negative 10 and Y will remain 0. While for moving upwards or downwards, we will set X value to 0 and change Y by 10. I will add a very small wait time so that the scroll value don't increase very quickly. The actual magic will happen when we use these scroll variables to move without moving. Switch to the map sprite. Our map will continuously see the values of scroll X and Y and move as they change. So in a forever loop, I'll set X to scroll X and Y to scroll Y. Let's run our code now. Whoa! We have successfully created a moving background and this actually looks like our character is moving. But only we know it is not even leaving its original spot. But there are few issues. If you notice, when I press the left arrow key, our sprite moves to the right. So all our keys are reversed. To solve this, before setting X and Y values, I will subtract scroll X and Y from 0. So that they get reversed. Let's run this. Awesome! This is perfect. you can change the starting position of the sprite by changing the value from which scroll is subtracted. Like if we use 200 instead of 0 for Y, our sprite will move down. I want my sprite to start from the top section, so I'll subtract from minus 200. Cool, our basic motion is complete. But our character is able to travel through the walls also. To tackle this problem in a simple manner, I'll create another sprite which will only have these boundary walls. And our character will only move if it is not touching this boundary sprite. To get the boundary, simply duplicate this map sprite. Open the costume editor. Select everything and click on ungroup. The basic idea is we will delete everything except the walls. If you don't want to go through this trouble, we have provided this sprite in the description too. Just upload it directly. Now that we have made our boundary, we can add a check in our main code that change the value of scroll X and Y only if our character is not touching the boundary sprite. Let us run the code to check if our logic worked or not. Okay, I am not able to cross the wall now, but I am stuck and cannot move either. To tackle this problem, we will have to move our sprite in reality this time. What we will do is, move the sprite by given X and Y value, so that this touching condition becomes false. And then move it back to its original spot, that is 0,0. If we don't do this, our sprite will be stuck on a boundary forever. This motion is very plain. Let us use all these costumes of our main character to create a walking animation. And that will be done by one block of code, which is next costume. Oh, I love the Scratch for being so simple. Well, our first part is almost ready and it's time to add sound effects. Only then will this game feel like the original one, right? I will start by adding background music in the backdrops code editor. Walking sound effects. For that, I'll create a separate block. And in a forever loop, check whether any arrow key is pressed or not. If pressed, I'll check the costume number of the sprite because I want to make sure that when I play the walking sound, the sprite's legs are touching the surface. See, here in costume number 3 and 8, legs appear to touch the ground. So I will use these two for now. Thank you. and start sound if any of these costume comes up. Since I have two different walking sound effects, I will play any of those randomly. And to add some extra effect, I will change audio randomly too. I think our game is ready. Let's try it out. I know you are really excited to play the game, but before that, I want you to like this video and share it with your friends. To make this more interesting, we will be releasing part 2 of Among Us as soon as this video crosses more than 5000 views and 200 plus likes. So hit that like button and subscribe to RoboFreaks. See you in the next video. Till then, happy learning, freaks!